Good evening everyone. So in the previous lectures we have covered first and second unit of the first module, that is management and construction project formulation. So in the today's lecture let us start with the third unit, that is construction planning and scheduling. So let us start with the introduction part, that is construction planning. So what is the importance of planning? What are the softwares used in planning? So we'll see in detail. So as we all know that planning plays an important role not only in the field of construction. If you consider any particular work or task, it plays a prominent role, because a particular work with a proper plan, if you execute without any interruption, then you can attain a maximum output efficiently. So for that reason planning is very important in all the field. So here the field of construction engineers use various methods of planning for a particular project. So if you consider any particular project to be planned, so you have number of methods for a planning. So most common methods used are Microsoft Project, that is MSP, and Primavera. So these are the two important planning softwares or tool, we can say, so which are used for a planning of a particular project. So because these two softwares will give a desired and maximum output, so for that reason these two softwares are used nowadays all over the world. So here the construction planning engineers visualize the sequence of activities to be executed in a project and present them in a graphical or table format. So by using these two softwares, the engineers, that is planning engineers, will visualize the sequence of activities to be executed in a project, and those activities will be arranged in a sequence wise, and that will be shown in a graphical way or table format in order to make it easy for the execution part. So here most common methods under those two softwares are, that is Gantt chart and PERT. PERT means Program Evaluation and Review Technique. So these are the two methods which will come under the softwares which are used in programming, planning and control of construction projects. So these two methods widely used in programming for a particular project and also the planning and controlling of that particular project. So these methods and applications can be used as an efficient and powerful project management tool or system. So So these two methods along with their applications are used as a powerful project management tool for a particular project, either it may be for planning or programming or control of that particular project. So this is about the introduction of the construction planning. So next comes the construction scheduling. So what it means? So as we know that schedule means it is just like a timetable or a format, we can say. So that is nothing but schedule in a general way. So here construction scheduling is a graphical representation which shows the phasing rate of a construction activities with their starting and completion dates and the sequential relationship among the various activities or operations in a project, so that the work can be carried out in an orderly and effective manner. So what it means, for any particular project it should have some scheduling part. So scheduling means a particular format or timetable. So if you consider, for example, any particular work or a project, so it will be having number of activities. So those activities should be carried out in order to complete that particular work or project. So what are the activities involved in that, and what are the relationship among those activities, and which activity should follow the other activities? So those sequential relationship should be known before the execution part, so that if you know that particular relationship between the activities, you can execute a particular project efficiently. So this is the meaning of construction scheduling. So scheduling means the entire total duration of a project will be calculated by knowing the number of activities involved in a project, and also by calculating the time required for each and every activities involved in a project. So if you calculate the time required to complete each and every activities involved in a project, so combiningly you will get the entire duration of a project. So that is nothing but construction scheduling. So it will be in a graphical representation in order to make it easy. So this scheduling will be shown in a graphical way. So that is it will be having two axes, that is one is y axis and another one is x axis. So in the y axis, what are the activities in a project? So the number of activities involved in a project, that will be shown in y axis, and time required to complete that particular activity will be shown along x axis. So combiningly we can get the entire duration of a project. So this is about the construction scheduling in a general way. So here our main aim is to find out the duration of a project. So next comes the preparation of construction schedule. So what are the steps involved in the preparation of construction schedule? So in order to get the duration of a particular project, so what are the steps need to be followed? So we'll see one by one. First step is the project is divided into number of operations or activities, and the sequence of these operations can be divided after knowing their relationship. So as I told that, so if you want to calculate the schedule of a particular project, then the first step what you should do, you should divide the entire project. So whatever the project you are handling, so that project will be divided into a number of activities or operations involved in that, and sequence of these operations. So sequence means serial wise arrangement of an activity in a project can be done after knowing their relationship. So for example, so I want to construct a house, so that is my project. So construction of house is a project. So I want to prepare a construction schedule for that particular project. So what I will do, first I will take that project, that is construction of house, and I will divide that project into a number of sub activities like cleaning of site is my first activity, next marking of the site, second activity, excavation of the site, third activity, substructure, fourth activity, superstructure, fifth activity, and finishing is the sixth activity. So likewise, I have divided my project into a number of activities with my relevance. So after that, what I did, so by knowing the relationship among the activities, I have arranged them in a serial wise. So how I arranged? First I have taken the cleaning of activities, after that it is followed by the marking, and that is followed by excavation. So likewise, the relationship between the activities I know, so in that way I have arranged the entire activities in a project. So I can't do marking before the cleaning part, I can't excavate before the marking part. So likewise, so you should know the relationship among the activities so that you can arrange them in a sequence or serial wise. So that is the first step you should do for in the preparation of construction schedule. And the second step is the quantity of work involved in each operation has to be calculated. So after arranging them in a serial wise by knowing the relationship, second step is, so what are the quantities involved in that particular activity that I should calculate? So how I should calculate? So what is my first activity? Cleaning of the site. So for cleaning of the site, I require 2 days. So depending upon the size of the activity or size of the project, so it will vary. But in my project, I require 2 days for cleaning of activities, and I require 1 day for marking of, that is layout marking. So likewise, I will calculate the quantity, that is time required for each and every activities involved in my project. So that is the second step. And the third step is the time required for the completion of a project and different activities are to be calculated. So depending upon the quantity, so I will get the time. So this is my 30-40 site or 60-40 site. So for cleaning purpose, I require 2 days. So this is my site. So for marking, I require, that is 1 day. 1 day is sufficient for my project marking. So likewise, depending upon the quantity, I will get the time, that is duration required for each and every activity. So combiningly duration of all the activities involved in my project, so I can get the entire duration of a project. So this is the preparation of construction scheduling. So for, if you consider, that is for first activity I require 2 days, for second activity I require 1 day, for third activity I require 15 days. So for fourth activity, I require 3 months. So likewise, depending upon my activities, I will calculate the, that is depending upon the quantity, I will calculate the time required for each and every activity to be completed. And I will add those time, or I will add those durations of each and every activity so that I can get my project duration. So entire project duration. So this is about the preparation of construction schedule. So next comes the uses of scheduling. So what are the advantage I can get if I schedule my project? So in that, first one is, it gives the quantity of work involved, labor, material and equipments for each stage of work. So as I told that, a proper scheduling will give the quantity of work involved. So with the, based on the quantity, I can calculate the time required for completion of that particular activity. So that leads to the calculation or computation of entire project duration. So this one advantage I can get by scheduling. So second one is, the actual progress of the work can be checked. So what it means, so before the execution part, so I will make schedule for a particular work or a particular project. So after the execution, easily I can compare with the standard one. So the actual progress of the work during the execution part, so that will be compared with the schedule prepared earlier for that particular project, so that it can be cross verified. So whether we are lagging in the project or whether we are ahead of a project, so that can be checked very easily. For example, so if my project is of 100 days means, so in the 50th day, so my, that is during the execution part, so I will, before the execution part, I will schedule my entire project. So I will get 100 days. 100 days is my schedule duration. So in that condition, during the execution part, that is after the 50th day, so my project should be completed 50%. So how I should know? So how I come to know that my project should be completed 50% after the completion of 50th day means? So by comparing with the standard one. So initially I have made a schedule of 100 days. So after 50 days means I should complete 50% of my work. So by comparing the actual progress with the prepared scheduled, so the progress of the project can be analyzed or checked or cross verified easily. So this is the second advantage I can get. And the third one is, by scheduling the project can be carried out in a systematic manner. So by proper scheduling, by arranging the activities in a sequence wise, by knowing the relation, so I can execute my project in a systematic manner one by one, so that I will not get any confusion during the execution part. So these are the advantages I can get by scheduling. So in the today's class, we have started with the third unit and we have covered the introduction part of construction planning and construction scheduling, and also the preparation of construction scheduling, and also what are the uses we can get from the scheduling part. So by this topic, we'll stop today here itself and we'll continue further. Thank you.